Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel, and my name is Sumit, and this is my second video related to the ClickView scripting basics. So in this video I will walk you through with how to use the if statement in ClickView scripting and how to create a hard code column for your dataset and the reason behind it. So let's see if there is a scenario where we can use if condition. So scenario is that I got a requirement that whenever you see the position name as level 3 sales representative or level 2 sales representative or level 1 sales representative, so I just wanted to change it to this short names. For example, level 3 sales representative, change it to L3, L-3, level 2 will change to L-2, and level 1 will change to L-1. So let's see how to do this in ClickView with the help of scripting. So for this, I'll go to script editor, open the script editor, and just after this position I will be writing the script. So what will be the script code over here? The script code will be I writing if condition if position equal level 3 sales representative, so then it should be changed to L3. This is one condition. Now I want to change this condition also, this position also, level 2 sales representative change to L2. So I add a comma here and I write a new if condition. So I'll just copy paste this condition over here and I write here, if this is level 2 sales representative, it will change to level 2. And again for third one, so I write here position equal to level 1 sales sales representative, it should change to level L1 representative L1, and if there is nothing, so it should remain the position. So bracket, 3 bracket close or 3 if condition close, 1, 2, 3, and it will be displayed as a new column. So new position and comma. So this is how to write the multiple if condition within the script in ClickView. So let's see if it's working fine or not. So I click on save and reload this. So you see the data, the script has been reloaded, but still it is displaying the same old values. Why? Because what we have to do is we have to go to its properties and add a column explicitly. So I right click on properties and add a new column position, and I delete this old position. Okay, let's leave it. Click on OK. So now you can see over here we have a new column added over here and the fees are populated over here, L3. This column level 3 sales representative changed to L3, level 1 changed to L1, level 2 changed to L2. So this is how you can use the if statement. Let us see how you can have a hard coded column. So basically what is hard coded column? Hard coded column in data set is nothing, just a column containing a value which is either calculated or coming directly from some data source. So let's suppose we have separate list for separate products and this list is associated with a product for sports gear. Anyway, let's say this list is associated with a sports gear. Now when you import data here, there is no particular column about it, that and we are not able to understand, or there is nowhere mentioned that this list is populated to which product. Maybe in data source you have the separate list for separate product category or for different product category. So to identify that which list is related to which column, we can have a hard coded column. For that we will just do some changes in the script. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new column here, hard coded column here, and that column will be display the list. Okay, so I'll click on edit script, and just after this work phone I add a new comma, and right here sports equipment as sports equipment and bracket close. There is no need of comma because it's the last one, and save it and reload. But the column will not add over here because we have to add it manually over here. So right click, properties, and I add a new column, sports equipment. Now I have the value populated for all of the rows. So this is how I can have a hard coded column. So I hope you may able to understand why do we have the hard column list. So this is pretty much, I wanted to give you an idea about the basic stuff in scripting in ClickView. I have few more things to discuss about the ClickView scripting. So I will meet you in the next video with some new and interesting topics. Till then, bye bye and have a great day ahead. And if you like my videos, you can visit more video, you can visit to our YouTube channel. Have a great day ahead. Bye bye.